there's grass coming through these cracks here. What's something else that might seep through cracks? What?
Bugs.
Bugs?
Bugs.
Thank you, bugs!
There's gonna be a lot of bugs still, so I'm just trying to work these bad boys out.
Okay, thanks. Sorry, I always just feel like such a pain in the ass when I gotta call IT. I didn't have a lot
fine.
Of stuff to do today.
Yeah, let me just put my hair up first.
hey, is it. I know you guys block Spotify, but maybe. Could you hook it up? I mean, if it's not too much to ask.
Say it again.
Really? Okay.
I can't do it with the door open, so say it again.
Can't unlock Spotify.
Can you do that? I'll show you Spotify. You show me something.
What are you talking about? What do you mean?
Hey, Bodie.
Yes,
hey,
what?
We're getting a lot of complaints. The music's being played too loud on the fourth floor. You know no Spotify's loud in this building here.
You ain't gonna believe what happened to me.
Bodie?
Listen, I got this guy in his office. He's a big slut once the door locks. This guy's like, here it is. Don't tell anybody.
No, I've already got Spotify. What are you doing here?
Hey, pervert, have a seat.
I got a lot of work to do.
Bodie is my best tech, okay? He's afraid to come on the fourth floor about something you showed him.
Well, that was a transaction, okay? We
both. Whoa, transaction!
Look, man, I work better.
You can't
than
do this, okay? This may be United States, but it's not pervert states, okay? Sicko.
What does it even mean?
It means you showed him his dick!
Alright, I'm respected on the fourth floor. Okay?
Not anymore.
Hey, alright. What do you want, okay? Just don't tell anybody. What do you want? What do you want, huh?
Nothing. I already told HR about it.
What? What do you...
I gotta report these things.
You've ruined my...
Yeah.
Funny how we never would have had to deal with this. I mean, what do you think about it? Isn't that the greater injustice of the situation? What is Spotify going to do to the workplace, huh? Motivate me? Huh?
I think it's probably less damaging than prostitution. Because you traded the showing of your genitals for a radio station.
I don't care if you're fired. Get out.
Please.
No. Please. You should not be up here, okay?
Look,
this is my office, and I'm not going to take what you have.
Look. What happened that day? What happened that day was bigger than Spotify or me showing you my penis. It's okay? I know you felt it too, all right?
Yeah, I'm in love with you so much.
There it is.
We can't do this. I'm in IT.
And I'm fired, okay? Whatever we want. What am I supposed to do?
Bodie, man, I can't officiate your wedding, okay? Come on!
What's something you wish you had control of?
Rust.
Your life, yeah.
Oh, God.
It's okay. Get it out.
Okay. Just feed the ducks!
No, I mean, I understand why you'd be upset.
Just feed them! Just feed the ducks, huh?
Just feed the ducks, he says. Like it's that easy for everyone, Derek! It's not!
So
ducks trigger me!
I'm just trying to help, okay? It's one thing. Just feed the ducks. Give it time. If you need time, take time. I'm here for you no matter how much time you need.
You need a new hobby. It's either drinking or feed ducks.
You guys, we knew our group therapy excursion to the park was going to be a challenge.
We all have our challenges.
But we need to be here for each other.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. I drove. Do it or you don't get a ride.
I'm feeling super betrayed by you right now, old man.
Old man, I'm 39.
you're the oldest of all of us. Yep. You're the old man in this group.
That's right, old man. That's old all man. I got. Old man.
Oldie.
You guys are party drunks. I drink for a sad reason.
What?
I drink for a sad reason, too.
What's your sad reason? Tell me. You're 22 years old. What can you fucking be sad about? All your clothes fit you exactly how they're supposed to.
Have you ever listened to Fall Out Boy?
Never once! You're still at an age where music can make you do stuff.
If I could jump across this pond, I'd punch you in the mouth.
Don't.
It's not that big, it's only ankle deep.
Oh, you're asking for it! Just because we know how to party doesn't mean that we don't have a problem, okay? I've partied. Yeah, okay? I can party all night long, all week long, all month long.
Yeah.
And then where am I?
Yeah.
Okay.
Where am I?
I'm losing my hearing.
I'm sorry if I triggered you with my loudness.
No, it's him.
It's me. I'm loud. I'm a little drunk.
You guys.
Are we all?
But the point is, we're here now. We gotta do this, you guys, together.
I've already been doing it for an hour, feeding the ducks, like we were told to.
But you don't understand.
I understand a shit ton more than you. I'm 39, you're 20. You have no idea what is in store for you. You still think miracles can happen and that you're gonna be a winner. You're a number!
I am gonna be a winner!
You will never be a DJ! You will never produce music!
Oh my
now
god,
she got her feet wet!
It's just fucking wild!
And then you just scared away the ducks. Now he's not gonna make any progress.
Never.
It's alright.
Yeah, find an older group, Grandpa.
I feel like you really judge us for not being old like you.
Yeah.
Everyone can have problems even when they're young. My dad killed the rest of my family, and I only made it up because I was hiding in the closet.
What, did you forget our therapy session?
I shared that like in week two.
I'm not going to mention
my old man. Shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, your wife.
She's a bitch!
My dad is a mass murderer!
That's sick, okay? That's gross! What do you want
yeah,
me to say?
So shut up!
I didn't know you were drinking because of that.
I told you!
I was thinking about my own stuff. My kid's in band.
Ding dong! Knock, knock. Who's there? It's reality.
Yep. Oh, sure.
You haven't said anything.
I don't want it.
He probably feels stymied because I yelled about him being loud.
No, because you keep talking about your family's murders.
Sorry.
We've talked about my sex addiction enough, all right? I want it.
Oh, my God. You still think, you're young enough to think that that's a curse. Sex addiction is the best thing you could possibly have. I'd kill for it. I'd literally kill a person to have a sex addiction.
Well, you can have mine because it's killing me.
Oh.
You're still young enough to think that that can be transferred to me.
I'm sorry.
I know, it's okay.
You need a new group of kids. They're just punk kids partying. You have some serious issues to deal with.
Oh, God.
Sweetheart. Listen. I know it's been a long time since you've seen me.
Oh, my God, you're out.
I escaped this morning. I escaped because Pat, you want to pass that over?
No!
Listen. It occurred to me while I was doing a hard time that I might have done some serious psychological damage to you. And I was,
hey, it's funny to run into you. I'm just feeding the ducks. I'm better now.
It's my dad.
Don't worry. I probably won't kill you. Listen. just came to apologize to my daughter.
Oh my God, everything's getting fixed. Huh?
No one's not gonna fix it.
You're gonna kill me.
No!
No, not you, oh. Damn it!
Listen, I've wanted to. I've thought about it. You know me, I'm not normally one for... I'm not normally one for leaving loose ends, you see.
Don't go away, Larry, Jesus!
I'm a duck thing, Larry. Sweetheart.
What?
I'm sorry. Can we just let bygones be? I mean, it was like 20 years ago.
Oh,
I paid my debt to society. I can't go to Buenos Aires without you forgiving me.
I'm going to throw up. Mostly because of what you said. Partly because of the alcohol.
But I'm sorry. Sorry I killed your mother.
Don't touch me when you take it, though. Grab the neck.
Why are you so afraid of forgiving me?
You killed everybody!
You're not gonna forgive me.
Adios.
I wrote this note for you, though. I hope you always take it.
Put it on the ground, I'll pick it up.
I think you're making a big mistake.
I don't want to touch you.
All right.
Good thing that bottle was here in the park.
I think once you read it, it'll be clear.
You're gonna write a poem and then I'll get it? Why you bludgeoned our family to death?
It's a very well written poem.
I'm sure it's a fantastic excuse.
All right. Is there anything you want to say to your old man before I leave?
Bye. Don't look sad. You don't get to look sad, you fucking murderer.
I just realized that my daughter's probably never going to forgive me for killing the family.
Nope. No, probably. I'm not ever. In any
and
way.
That does make me feel bad.
Good. The rest of the family can't feel anything. I'm mostly without real emotion, other than wanting to cut myself, so...
I have your flesh and blood. I can help you through this.
You misspelled bludgeon, by the way. Damn!
That was about a bad dad. What's something good that your dad could do for you?
Take you camping.
Thank ya.
Story?
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Dan. I get a little nervous at these times, but I'm excited.
Careful, don't get too close to the fire.
Oh, okay. I won't. Okay. I won't, it's warm.
All right.
Hey, you mind if I come over and listen? I'm sure I got to stay over here by myself.
Jellystone has a pretty strict policy.
I'm just standing here.
Come on in.
Whoa.
Hey, it's the Yogi Bear spirit. We have friends.
Walk in.
All right?
Thanks.
Just what's your name, bud?
Jeff.
Alright, nice to meet you.
I love ghost stories.
I'm Ron, these are my two kids, Todd and Tom.
I'm Todd, he's Tom.
We sing it so we remember. He's Todd, he's Tom.
We're a happy family.
Yeah, it's a good time.
Alright, let's keep the ghost story, huh?
Hi, yeah, ghost story. Alright. So, you kids heard the story about the phantom around these woods, huh?
No.
No.
That's true. Now, a phantom, you see, a phantom is different than a ghost. A phantom is a tortured soul. Right? Yeah, I know. And they say many years ago, back when there was an old logging facility here, the lumberjacks, they would gather around, right? They'd gather around for dinner after a hard day's work of chopping trees down, right? Except one of the lumberjacks was very disgruntled, okay? It felt like he wasn't paid well. All the other lumberjacks were very sick of his attitude. They thought they were paid proper wages, and they thought they didn't need to renegotiate after a very So they took the disgruntled lumberjack, and many argue this was an overreaction, but they tied him to a piece of plywood and ran through a bandsaw, just like that. They call him the split phantom. They say he can find his left side or his right side, just floating around. But once a year, on a full moon, just like tonight. Hey, wait a second. What's the date? What's today's date? Anybody know? Anybody know what today's date is?
March 23rd.
March
My God.
23rd.
March
Wednesday?
23rd. Wednesday, March 23rd.
Wednesday.
50 years to the date. Pretty crazy. Pretty crazy. But they say you're fine, unless the phantom fuses together.
I want to go home. I don't want to camp anymore, Dad. This
is
no fun.
It's just a tall tale. It's fake story. Yeah, it's a tall tale.
Don't worry about it. I got all sorts of guns over here. You
there's no guns allowed in Jellystone. Very strict about that.
Well, I have licenses.
All right. It's just, you know, I think the kids are going to make me a... What's that, bud? Hey. Tom, Todd, Tom, and he is Todd. All right. What's that?
Just saying.
What? They act like a bunch of scaredy cats. What's going on here?
Doesn't it look like he has a mark?
That lumberjack comes around, he's not going to be too much trouble for my bushmaster.
That's cute. You gave a nickname to your gun. I like that. That's cool.
Ask him what his favorite tree is.
You can ask him, son.
No!
What's your favorite tree?
I like maples.
Just because he has a preference in trees doesn't mean... All right, okay. Hey, my sons think you're the phantom, the split phantom. But we know that's not true. The split phantom is just a tall tale that's been around this area for centuries.
Ghost story, right?
Yeah.
Dad!
So tell my kids you're not the split
phantom. Dad! Dad, he's wearing carpenter pants.
That's a style choice.
Lumberjacks wear carpenter pants.
Look, can you just tell the kids you're not the split phantom? I'm not the split phantom.
Split phantom, where have you been? I stay here. I take care of this part of the forest. You're taking advantage of Bigfoot.
I got some good supplies for us, okay? Enough shit to get us through the spring, you know. I know. I've been neglecting you, okay? You're very special.
It's
to me,
just
right?
So hard pretending I don't exist. I want people to know me. I'm very caring.
Well, why don't you come on with me next time? Huh?
All right, I know last night was scary. I'm just going to tell you guys an easier story, because you two get... it's a sanctioned camping zone. It's safe. They don't even have squirrels running around.
We made it through one night. Can't we just go home?
Oh, come on.
I earned my badge, Dad. Earned it.
It's a fake badge I made in the car, but whatever you want to say. Now, look, I'm going to tell you another ghost story, because you can see to toughen up, all right? But this one, have you ever heard of the old Sasquatch? Have you heard of that one?
No.
Even the Native Americans.
I've heard about them.
Come on. Just come on.
Just me, not split phantom. Remember?
Obviously.
Not split phantom, me. Yeah, remember?
It never happened.
Not split phantom. But hey, I brought a buddy along with me.
Oh.
Okay?
Of course.
first see him. He's a big, big, hairy guy. Okay. All right.
Maybe like inbred or something. I mean, just, you look like a local, and that seems like a thing.
Well, yeah. I honestly don't.
If you're inbred, I'm sorry. Can I come over now?
Come on in, bud.
Oh wow! I thought that was a Hollywood costume. That's amazing.
Hi.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
I'm.
Huh?
Dad!
Be tender, Sam Squatch.
I'm Sam. Sam.
Sorry, one second, my voice.
They're gonna know.
Tom and Todd, what
this
you
fake beard is gonna do nothing. He said, Sam Squatch. You know how close this Sam Squatch is? I'm only a little kid and I can see it. Why can't you see it? What are your problems?
Look, you kids just keep pointing fingers at nice, innocent people. I mean, meanwhile, you two are like scaredy cats of the corn, just saying weird stuff and clinging on to each other. You're the ones acting like weirdos. That's what everyone's saying. Take it from your dad. You're a weirdo.
May I talk to the boys?
Wow. Wow. You have an aggressive palm, but yeah, go right.
Sit down, boys. Take a knee.
Listen to the nice man.
I know what it's like to be afraid. I'm afraid every time I went out of my place, people would want to kill me or take my picture. Or take my picture and then kill me. Or get a shot of me after they killed me, which they never did.
is he wanted by the law or something?
Don't shake your hand. Don't be afraid. Listen, I know what you're going through. Living a life of fear is no good. It's gonna force you to ball yourself off from the world. Be with people who take you for granted! Just because you don't feel you deserve better. Well, I'll tell you something. You boys do deserve better. And Bigfoot deserves better. Don't be afraid.
That was a fake beard.
But everything else is real. Including the way that I feel.
That's the most beautiful thing I've ever heard. Go ahead. This whole time, you knew what you were supposed to say a word.
Look, I hang out with them. We do stuff together, all right? I don't want people. There's pictures, okay? It could get out.
Look, our family only has one rule. Isn't that right, boys?
Yeah.
We don't
lie.
We don't lie. You guys really need to pick up on that rule. We don't lie, all right? And I know you're a new friend, but you started off with a lie, okay?
All right, well, you know what? I'm a split fam, all right?
Some people have secrets. What's your secret?
Deodorant.
Ooh. Oh,
God, this feels so good to shower when it's cold out.
There's deodorant in the bag if you need it when you're done.
Hey, it's extra if you watch.
Not watching. I'm
all right.
You the fucking shower.
I don't use deodorant. I have a genetic disorder.
It's Tom's.
I'll use it.
I have very sensitive skin, so I have to use it.
Hey, Wachowski. Hey!
Hey, there's a line for the shower, dude.
I was just gonna double up with Kowski. We do it all the time. What's the big deal? It's a big deal.
Figure it out.
Yeah. Come on, Aaron. Yeah. I'll wash your ponytail. So I thought I'd chat with you about this beat that the commander wants us on.
Uh-huh.
Maybe pick your brain about it.
Yep.
So that's a pretty largely Puerto Rican neighborhood.
Oh, I'm down. Saying,
huh?
I'm down.
All right.
I love popping Puerto Ricans in the head with my billy club.
Speak Spanish?
Si.
Can I talk to you, partner?
Yeah.
All the other guys are put off by you. You know, we go through a lot accepting you, you know, and stuff. You're the first woman on the force. We love you. Hey, we think you're a damn fine cop, but listen.
You say woman like I'm an alien or something.
Well, to us, you kind of are. But listen. You gotta start showering with these guys.
It doesn't strike you weird that that's like part of the culture in this precinct that you guys like double up in the shower?
I just work here, okay? That rule was established along. It's supposed to be.
A rule?
It's a team building thing, Callaway. God damn it. You wanna make sergeant?
Hey, Clean Factor.
Hey.
Just to play on your last name, Cleaner. That's all.
Hey! What?
Shower, 3:30.
You know I'm in. Callaway?
No!
Can I get him in?
Great.
Kowski.
I mean, you know.
Kowski, give me a second.
All right. All right. You want me to hang out somewhere else?
Just it's like 3 feet over there.
Well, can I borrow a dollar?
Shower.
I want to use a vending machine.
All
I don't
right.
have my pants on.
Do you have any skin left? All you can do is shower.
What, are you afraid of being clean?
No.
He rides a cop horse all day.
Yeah. That thing smells bad.
Don't listen to Callaway. She's pissed because she won't shower.
Damn one that's not so crinkly.
Yeah.
I never get that to work. I don't know what
least I can do for a guy I shower all the time.
All right. This one I'm keeping for later.
There you go.
All right.
I don't want to jump to any conclusions here. This isn't my usual MO, but don't you think it's kind of interesting that all these guys are showering with other guys?
You trying to say, like, there's sexual undertones to us? Is that
I'm
what you're trying to say?
I'm just wondering if that's there.
We were told this is a team building exercise. Do we kiss in there? Oh, absolutely. You save a man's life, you feel something.
Ah!
Whoa! Oh my
god! Oh, I can't breathe!
Come on, let's get it off it!
Oh my
god!
Mikowski!
Help!
Officer down! Officer down!
Partner, what the fuck happened to him?
Did he get out of the car?
Hey, I tracked you down.
Oh my god!
I'm his twin.
Oh,
I got a gun in my head, I'm gonna kill
you. Oh
no,
god.
Me?
Why would you kill him?
You
always kill,
a ghost.
Kill her!
Say what you gotta say to my ex-partner.
Stop.
Hey. I'm playing the bagpipes at my brother's funeral this afternoon, and you're the goddamn blame.
Fuck you.
I'm out.
Hey, we're going to bowling later if you want to.
Hang on, hang on. Let me just my phone, man. It's just my phone. I'm gonna WebMD injury by vending machine phone.
Do you have an extra gun I could use real quick?
Right, yeah.
Don't give him a gun, he wants to kill me!
Hey, he's the brother of
my
dead friend.
That's right.
You spit a lot.
Yeah. Is that a habit?
It is.
It's a shitty thing.
What are we doing exactly?
I'm just trying to see what you're supposed to do when a vending machine falls on a person.
Brian, get him in the goddamn shower! I know that!
Normally don't take cases like this that I know are gonna... I'm gonna lose in the court.
What?!
But... I understand, I get it. I hate showers too, alright? That's why I'm doing this for free. Although you should have had your partners back in there, I'm gonna defend you in court for free, okay? But look...
Because
ultimately it was my fault. I was the one who let him down in the shower.
Wow. Okay.
What are you doing in my lawyer's office?
This case is...
I'm your witness.
This
I'm
case
be
has
your
got
character
legs.
Witness.
All right. All right? As long as you don't reach an untimely death before the trial, we should be okay.
It wasn't your fault. I had his back. I had his direct back in the shower. I know what happened. And it was me. It was my fault. The only reason the shower didn't save his life was me.
Okay.
Hey! I made that sound with my mouth on purpose.
What do you want, Wachowski's twin?
There's a thin blue line.
Yeah.
You crossed it, pal.
Well, somebody's gotta have the balls to say what's true.
Yeah. Like,
sometimes showers don't save people's lives.
I forgot my gun!
Well,
so I'm pointing at
you. Alright?
I'll be back later.
Okay. Try it.
Alright, you two are gonna have to live together until the trial, okay?
That's a sick time.
That's somehow I feel on the team. Like am I everybody else agrees. I don't
It can be a challenge being the only girl sometimes.
I
really wouldn't know, but I hear. What's something else that's a big challenge?
Jellyfish.
Jellyfish are challenging.
Yes, it is.
You're supposed to pee on him.
Oh, I
pee on me, man!
You
gotta
I'm
just jogging.
Fucking pee on me!
I don't have to go right now.
Yeah.
He got stung, so could you pee on my head?
He was his partner for the jellyfish challenge, so you used to have to pee on his leg.
Pee on me!
Okay, all right.
Just, where is it? Where
he was pointing at the other one.
Which foot? That's it. I'm not going to generally pee on you. Tell me.
Well, I mean, it'll trickle down. Right,
just start at the top.
I can't believe that happened.
It feels less sexual if you're standing. So if you could stand, because right now I'm just like it, I don't. This is like,
I'll tell you what, the IRS is looking very closely at your pee on me, I tricked you videos. There's a lot of income that's gone unreported.
Let me shoot straight with you,
okay? Hey. Hey. I'm with you guys as your accountant.
Yeah, so let's make some real money. Who are we gonna pay out next?
Look, I.
No,
claim him as a dependent. He's older than both of you.
Yeah.
Yes, but it was my original ideas.
Yeah. We adopted him, and then I mirror him so people feel welcome.
Right,
Southern people are
so she's
welcome.
My mommy and my wife.
Yeah.
They found me in a barn, so they just raised me as their father.
This is all great. He's my husband.
It's a good daddy boy.
Oh, I know.
And it's been
great. You know this is all great exposition, but you know that I have heard it all before. You're not going to hear it out for a while.
Yeah, well, you just act like you don't get us.
Well, it's just my demeanor. I have to navigate my ways through the straight world.
Why are you so proper?
Because my father raised me on a farm in Minnesota.
Honey, I don't know what you did on your trip, but I'm not into that.
It lit a fire in my head, and now I can't put it out. I need you to pee on that fire.
No, my God. 12 years of marriage and 4 kids does not constitute pee.
Look, I'm sorry, okay? I met those weird inbreds. I'm viral. I'm famous now, and I'm hungry. I want more.
Hi. You know? Carl Slappingson.
How did you get in my bedroom?
Funny story. I'm good at breaking into things.
Okay.
That's a minor story compared to what you're going to learn in a moment. Take a look at this portfolio.
Yeah.
Are you absorbing these numbers as I flip through these pages? Well, let me explain them to you then. You're about to be a millionaire.
Are you an accountant?
Yes.
I'm always getting married.
Because I'm so proper. Are you his wife?
Yes.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
And she's just not dressed handsome. Okay.
You didn't tell me that enough anyway.
Look,
so
why are you here? Well, I broke into your house because I thought I could get some money out of you and also get you involved in the peeing on people business.
Are you suggesting an alternative channel to the popular peeing on people just kidding videos to compete with them?
Well, there's actually a couple of subgenres. One is I peed on you, I tricked you, and
okay.
I peed on you, just kidding.
Okay.
You would be I pee on you, I didn't mean it. Look, I know it sounds weird. I know this is all moving very fast.
What?
Here's 10 grand.
Oh, yeah.
Cool.
Well, I guess I can count on you at the annual peeing on awards in the fall.
Oh, right. Oh, that competes with the Grammys.
It does. It's in the fall.
Look. Yes. I know a lot's happened in the last 90 seconds.
A lot.
A lot of information was conveyed. Mm-hmm. A lot of it. But I need you on board with this, okay? Because we're a unit, all right?
Mm.
And if I'm going to change careers, I need you there with me.
Mm.
You didn't have to ask.
Mm.
You didn't have to ask. I love you so much.
If there's one thing I love more than peeing on people, it's emotional connections.
What's something really weird that you've watched?
Improv.
Improv, yeah. For the class?
Yeah.
Me too.
All right, guys. Sorry, we don't have enough chairs.
All three of us are here for the class. We didn't know. Should we choose who gets the chair, or you want to choose?
No, it's not an exercise.
Sorry, but
rope theater.
Sorry, I'm
late. My name's Terry. Welcome to class. Not gonna lie, I'm like super hungover right now.
Classic. Me too.
What kind of shows? You like?
Are you completely serious?
What's?
Improv shows?
No, I'm just joking.
Yeah.
You're probably performing for like 100 people a time, right?
Probably.
Right. You're rich, right?
No.
Wait, what?
No, I drove an escort here.
Oh, it's worse than my car.
Yeah.
And I drove with him here. I don't even have a car. I figure once I get through these classes, I'll probably start making money.
Don't say you're going to end up on SNL, please.
But how do you do that?
I'm just trying to break out of my show because I'm paying for the
Get this soccer mom out of here.
Hey, she has just as much of a right.
and you know it.
Look, listen, listen.
It was either going to be this, Toastmasters, or Dale Carnegie. She took this.
Hey, Terry, I'm working on a character, right?
Take the stage.
Yeah. You know, he just comes in like, I'm going to open the door.
Oh, fuck.
And I'm just going to shimmy into you.
Oh, no. And
a picture me with a mustache.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. How, we can't picture you with mustache. There's not costumes or props in this art. Did you know that? You can't put on a mustache you don't have.
Well, like theater of the mind.
Yeah,
theater of the mind.
So, you're taking improv classes, huh?
Yeah, that's right.
Hi, I'm Mikey Gutting, and I teach at the Planet.
Improv's something you could teach. What's something else you could teach? Karate? Karate? Thank you, karate.
Yeah, I'm taking the class.
All right, guys.
Hey, are you rich? How do I get on SNL?
Massaging.
Alright.
I just gotta ask.
What?
You came on SNL.
That's a good question.
Sorry, I'm here to do massaging.
Welcome. Thanks for coming.
Charlotte, how dare you? You knew I wanted to take this massage class.
We used to go to class. You take the improv class, you take the karate class, I didn't take the massage class, you didn't come here.
I did do this because I'm Dad's favorite.
But I should get one. You get 2 hours here. I get one. I'm going to do the massage.
Okay.
You know what? I hate you so much.
Just shattered, like it all just like blew up, and I was like doing it. Like, I didn't touch anything though. I just did it in my head.
Well, you take me fucking seriously for 1 minute, Scott.
Oh my god, don't yell at me.
Okay, but you just you read your comments and you never really listen to me, and I think something really effed up happened last
night.
Dude,
we're not. Okay. How many times I've wished it for it to happen, but we're not really super.
I'm just saying. I think I might be.
Is this your locker, Dork?
Yeah, it's my locker.
Well, it's mine now.
I didn't want a locker. That's weird.
You gotta collect them. What are you gonna do about it?
Dude, don't touch me, okay?
What's your combination?
I have it a week. I'm not telling you my combination, man.
What are the gayest numbers in the number?
What kind of question is that?
Because that's probably your what are you gonna do about it?
Back off.
No! Let me go!
I don't know.
Let me go! God! You
friends. I haven't taken off my sunglasses in like 3 weeks, but look, watch this.
Whoa!
Oh, I know.
Wait, so like, technical question.
Yeah.
Does it just bounce back and forth? Or like, what's going on?
It stops it. It just stops
it. Where does it go?
It filters it.
It's so
weird. You know like a coffee filter, how that works?
Yeah, but then
I mean,
it still
seriously,
goes somewhere.
How does your thing work? Do we ever gonna know?
I don't know. Hey, yours is a little plot hole, in my opinion.
Well.
Hey, I saw what happened in the hall.
Oh.
I thought I was the only one at the school.
What? You do too?
Whoa. I throw fireballs.
That's awesome. That's so cool. What do you do with them?
They're kind of strong. They go through a lot of walls. I don't really have it down yet.
That's cool.
Just started a couple of nights ago.
Really?
Yeah.
Mine started like last week, and I don't know mine either. I just like I get angry, and then I just kind of like do some Minority Report stuff with my hands. No! Oh my god! Oh my god! I'm so sorry.
No, that was cool.
It just like it just like froze. Did it hurt?
It was kind of like these bony hands were holding me up by my throat.
Alright, so you got a girlfriend from your powers, but I need one.
Well, that's not the point of the powers, man.
I'm lonely.
Well, this girl in my gym class has gills.
Really? That sounds awesome. Do you have laser eye?
Yeah, I have gills, but no special powers, just gills. Time for the ant jam. If you want to get in on the jam, get your name in on the jam jar. We are the home team, but tonight we are called Rumpleforeskin. Individually, we are
Karen,
Sean,
Travis,
Louis,
Michael. Thanks, guys.